Hey, this is Pat Cox, and welcome to an Oath of the Gatewatch draft here on Channel Farble. Just FYI, this is during the pre-release, so this is a Swiss draft. Sometimes people ask, oh, is this Swiss or 8-man? It's pretty much always 8-man unless it's pre-release and those aren't available. So, open to Eldrazi Mimic, which I've seen be... It basically goes from decent to, like, very good. You know, I've definitely played against it where my opponents kept playing giant actual Eldrazi that, you know, it's like 6 or 7 power. Other times they'll just play, you know, make it maybe a 3-3 or, a 2-2 instead of a 2-1 or something, which is fine, but I'm not super excited by it. I think Oblivion Strike's probably a better card. I mean, this does have the advantage of going in any deck technically, but there's some decks that just aren't really going to have any colorless guys, like, you know, green-white or something. So yeah, I think Strike's the best card. I like this guy, but don't really like picking gold cards too high, and obviously doesn't necessarily go with our first pick. Kozilek Shrieker is pretty decent. It definitely does go with our first pick, but Isolation Zone does also, like, black-white is a pretty good deck, and it's certainly the best card in the pack, I think, so we'll go with that. Okay, Make a Stand is okay. I had it in a black-white deck that was kind of turtling up, and eventually I, you know, would use it to kind of be able to Alpha Strike with Impunity, and it was okay there. I mean, it's also just a combat trick in general, but nothing too exciting. I think Step Glider's pretty good, probably at its best in green-white, but could still be good in white-black. Also not even necessarily white black. Like, we're not necessarily white black. Aeronaut is a card I've actually come up on. You know, 1-3 fire for 2 is generally not all that exciting, but support's a pretty big thing in white, so it's not that hard to, if you make him a 2-4, suddenly it's a pretty real card. I think we'll just take the glider, though. Well, Birthing Hulk is a really good card. It just costs 7, but you know, when you get it into play, you're pretty likely to have it survive, and you know, it's not like it's totally going to win the game, but it will dominate the board a lot of the time. You know, just if you don't know what it does, it makes 2 signs and comes into play, and you can pay 1 and a colorless to regenerate it. So, pretty good card. But it doesn't really go with anything we have so far. The card that goes the best with what we have so far is definitely Raptor. Yeah, I think that's probably the pick. Okay, well, we haven't seen a lot of these commandos, which are actually quite good. Preston Service is also quite good. Not actually even sure which of those I would rather have, just because, like, Preston Service is certainly a more powerful card, but, you know, you gotta factor in just, we already have a couple fives, you do need some cheap stuff, like, especially if you're trying to support, you know, definitely want 2-drops. If we're gonna be in red, this is probably the best 2-drop. Not that we necessarily want to be in red, but, you know, kind of the best cards in the pack are probably those. Like, Translator is a good card, but it's not really in the deck that we're trying to get. Lead by Example is also a good card, so we'll see. We're white something right now, I think. Yeah, I guess like another Raptor, which makes me glad I did not take another 5-drop last pack, despite it probably being just power level a little better. This card's a rare, right? What a crap rare. Yeah, we'll take the Raptor. Well, take Free Runner. We still don't even know if we're really red. Or you take Cinder Barons. That would potentially let us splash the Oblivion Strike. None of this is really all that exciting. I don't really think I'm gonna want either of these cards. So I guess we'll just go with this. Well, again, more cards I don't really want. Though Chain Mage can certainly be good in a white-black deck if we end up there. It's kind of hard to. We're white something right now, which makes me a little bit more inclined to take a white card just because then I can stay open and decide what I want. Guess Spine Binder is probably a little bit better than Protector. Ooh. All right, well, that to me indicates red is open, but maybe people don't like this card. I'd say odds are right now red it's really a decent chance I'm gonna play a second Spinebinder Mage versus like might just side this in probably. Yeah, like I'm not really looking to play the Alpha Protector or Spinebinder Mage, but I will play them. But they're not. If I find something else, I'll be happier. Well, I don't really see myself playing a Seer's Lantern. Guess that card's kind of good against me. Could potentially play that to turn on Surge. I think that's what it's supposed to be for. I've yet to do that, but. Okay, well, Sylvan Advocate's great. I mean, just a card that's relevant early and late is very good. Though we're not in that color, so that's not really an option. Haven't actually played with this card yet, though it seems like it should be at least decent. And this card is probably going to be great in our deck because, all the white guys are allies. We're all allies right now, so just as a looter. Though I think it's still got to be Boulder Salvo. This card's just so good. Well. This card's okay. I'm probably not ever getting to 7 mana in my deck, so I think we just want another Boulder Salvo. Also, Raptor and Scythe Master are both quite good. but yeah. Alright. Well, this is the kind of deck that's most likely to make use of this because there are like a few different equipment payoff cards, so the actual equipment's kind of whatever. Like, I'm not super excited about playing Bone Saw or Strider Harness or anything. So I guess I'll just take Shock. I've not loved this in the format because there's so many 2/3s, but it's fine, it's still Shock. Okay, I think we want Flame Speaker. Probably a decent chance it comes back, but I actually kind of would like the shoulder to shoulder in this deck. Like, I got multiple first strike guys, I got this guy that, cares about me guys having plus one counters, so I think it could be good here. Haven't actually, I don't think I've played with this card yet, maybe I've played with it like once, but I've seen it in other people's decks and it does seem better than I thought it would be. Like, at first people were like, oh, that's like travel prep. It's like, it's pretty far from travel prep, but that doesn't mean it's not still a fine or a good card. But yeah, this looter guy's pretty nice. Well, I don't really need more fives. Got already too many of those. So both these cards are pretty good, but I don't think they're what I want. I mean, I guess, I was just talking about shoulder to shoulder potentially being okay, so I guess I'll take that. I definitely need some more early stuff for me to be too excited about this card, but yeah, I mean, there's also, I guess, potentially turns where I could, like, shoulder to shoulder into this or something. This guy can be cheap, but I'd rather really need more actual cheap stuff, like turn on my Boulder Salvos, turn on the other one of these, that kind of thing, so. The deck has good cards. I just really need to find the earlier end of the curve. Alright, what's Tears of Valakut? Like, kills a flyer. Yeah, that's. By taking the other Cinder Barons, I'd already be at the point where I could splash Oblivion Strike, but I think I just want Core Sky Climber. Do I want a third Free Runner or a second Shoulder to Shoulder? I really have no idea. I mean, I'm testing for the Pro Tour, so I guess, you know, if I think Shoulder to Shoulder might be good, maybe this is the time to be figuring it out. Can't really imagine I want that many, like, 4-drop creatures, but I guess we'll give it a try. I don't know. It's just like, this guy's. It's annoying because, like, surging into him, I mean, he gets you two things in a turn, but, you know, just a 3-2 that far into the game, even with Menace, is just kind of okay. It's not. So maybe the other ones get better if I can make them 4-3s. I mean, just being able to not just trade with a 2-3 is fairly important. So there's so many of those in this format. Alright, well, I don't really like Searing Light at all, so let's take another Flame Seeker. Well, Tar Snare, while not a good card, is actually kind of good against me. I have a bunch of 3-2s, so I could just take it so I don't have to play against it. I could also take Bonesaw, which I doubt will be good in my deck, but it does, like, turn on these other things. All the equipment payoff stuff's gonna already be kind of be gone by the. You know, it's only in this pack, really, so. Guess I'll take Bonesaw. I don't think I'm gonna play Bonesaw. Well, there's a payoff guard right there. Still probably don't think I'm gonna play it, but it's really not much of a payoff. It's, save one mana. It's like, can I see a scenario where I side in two Spark Mage's Gambits? I guess I'm a little low on creatures. I should probably just make sure I get enough. Even though I'm probably not going to play that guy. These are both pretty good black cards. Like, I actually like this card a lot. This Boon of Erebos type card. Probably don't want my opponent to gain 6 life. Probably cut the cards. I'm not necessarily planning on playing. I mean, I might play them, but probably look more like something like this right now. This is a pretty good pack for me. So I don't have like, I mean, I have a decent number of core things. Like, this card got significantly better just because you get vigilance and then can use any of these abilities in the same turn while attacking. It's pretty nice. I think Outnumber's favored to be quite good in this deck, though. Like, I don't have a lot of creatures yet, but I mean, I have some in the sideboard I can put in, and you know, I'm probably gonna get more in this pack, and just this very easily. It's kind of like a Boulder Salvo. It's very easily lets me to do two things in one turn, which is kind of what I'm looking for. Fireman Mage is pretty great, just giving all your guys menaces. You know, when you're an aggressive type deck, is a good way to kind of end the game. But I think it's probably still outnumber here. Well, Cohort got like a good bit better in that everything's an ally in the second set, so like my whole deck's allies. So as long as I have another creature, I don't have to suicide this guy. I still think probably the 3/1 guy's better, because at least it can trade with the 2/3. Also, Valakut Invoker's pretty great. I don't know that my deck's necessarily going to get to 8 mana that often, though, so. This is a lot more on plan to just get more 2 drops. Well, Angel Renew could definitely be a decent finisher in this deck. Again, still, I don't know that it's going to be better than just. Sheer Drop's probably not going to be good because I'm going to be the one attacking. I think. So it's kind of between Core Gastigator and Angel Renewal. Angel's certainly the better card, but we already have a decent amount of expensive stuff and are pretty low on cheaper guys. So I think it is this, which is kind of weird. Okay, so Gaiden's Reproach is probably good enough to still play. I mean, I do have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 removal spells that I don't have to get blocked first to use. I could play Slide Runner, even though it's not an ally. It's not that big of a deal since almost everything else is an ally. Could also play this guy. It triggers rally trigger is decent. It's not gonna do a whole lot in my deck. Yeah, I should probably take Gideon's Reproach, I guess. I have like these other guys on the sideboard that are mediocre, but I can play if I need to. Or Tandem Tactics might actually be okay. These kind of weird picks where it's just like I would have never imagined I would be debating some of these things that I know him. Right, well, I might play that guy. Ooh. This card's so good, but 7 is so much mana. I might take it just because I don't want to face it. I don't know that I'm actually going to play it. I might sideboard it in if I. I don't know. It's like 7 is, I mean, it is pretty good, though. Alright, well, Boiling Earth screws me pretty bad, so I wonder if I should just take it so I don't have to play against it. Inspired Charge is probably not something I'm going to need or necessarily even want. Invoker, again, I don't know that I'm really going to get the 8 mana. Courier Griffin is fine. That'd be a fine card to play in my deck. Ooh, man. Just like I have so many things that die to Boiling Earth, like all my 2-drops. Yeah. Ooh, that's a late Stone Fury. I do like McKinty Patrol, but maybe it's still just Stone Fury. I have like so many fives. I mean, Boulder Salvo isn't exactly a five because I can play two things in the same turn, but I still have to like cast it turn five. Guess I'm gonna take the patrol with a very low confidence level. Alright, well, Kitescale Scout might actually be okay in my deck because I got multiple support things. I mean, it's probably favored to be better than the cohort at the least. I don't know that I'm gonna play any of this, but like I do have four cards that support. Yeah, I don't know that any of this really matters. Take my extended playable, I guess. Or modern. Extended hasn't existed for a while. I'm aging myself here. I don't really want either of these cards. All right, well, gotta make at least a few cuts. Yeah, I'm not really sure about Cliffside Lookout or Kitescale Scout. I mean, again, if we end up playing all these support cards, they're gotta be at least okay. Like, if you go 1-drop, 2-drop, shoulder to shoulder, you're probably winning that game. But it's more later in the game when you top deck one of these, is it gonna do very much? I mean, 5 to pump all your guys is okay. It's, not super exciting. I also don't know if I really want to play the spike. I mean, 7 is so much mana. Feel like there's going to be a lot of games. Like, my deck's kind of trying to win quickly, so I feel like there's a lot of games where I'm just going to have this sit in my hand. But it is very powerful, and if the board does stall, it's going to help me break that and hopefully win. So, yeah, it's hard. I still think I'm going to play 17 lands even without that because I have all these 5 drops. Though I might not even want Step Glider. You would think I do. That also breaks board stalls with all these guys. I don't know. Feels like weird to cut Spike, but I also don't know that my deck really wants a 7 drop. Sorry, I also don't know that my deck wants Gideon's Reproach, just because I have plenty of other removal that doesn't mean I have to get blocked first or anything. Maybe I still am supposed to play that, I don't know. I mean, I do wonder if I can get away with 16 lands like this. Like I said, I still think probably not. I don't know what the last code is here. It's like the Kitesail Scout is definitely better in like nut type draws than the Cliffside Lookout, but in longer games I would rather have the Cliffside Lookout. I mean, maybe I'm supposed to just play both. It's possible Shoulder to Shoulders are cuts too, but I'm just trying to try out that card, so I don't really want to cut it. I guess the other thing with Spike is like when I have two of this looter guy and I'm discarding all these lands, trying to make sure I keep having gas, it seems unlikely I'm gonna get to the mana to cast Spike. See, I might just not be very good in my deck. I mean, despite the good synergy with Cohort, it's possible a McKindy Patrol could be cut. It's also possible a Free Runner could be cut. I just think that card's kind of mediocre. Just yeah, you can surge into it, but it's still just a 3/2. It's not doing enough. Maybe I just don't even want to play this card. If I cut these, then what can I play? Is Tapper better? I mean, there's like. I guess I should probably play at least one Tapper when I have McKindy Patrol, because that is actually pretty sick. Attacking with everything and then tapping before blocks. Yeah, I'm not real sure about these couple one drops. Should I just be playing 2/4 drops over them? Just better cards, but basically, does the shoulder to shoulder do enough to make it worth playing these kind of mediocre cards? Don't know the answer, but I guess we'll find out. I guess that's why we're testing, right? Okay, I will see you guys for round one.